What's going on, guys? Welcome back. Tam here. So this video is inspired by somebody who actually contacted me about their product. Now, the story is that this person contacted me who I can't say what their name is or what the product is, just for to keep their own privacy private, right? So, and he wanted some help. He was running a PPC campaign and he wanted some help. So, as usual, I'm like, you know what? Send me your stuff. Send me what you're selling. Show me what you're doing and let's sort this through. So he sends me the product and I was shocked, guys. Like, it was a product that was in a very niche market. The competition was really high. And I ran my own Jungle Scout on that and Merchant Words and all that kind of stuff to see if I'm right, because from the first look, it looked off, right? So it turns out that this product was not what he should be getting, what he should have gone into. And my immediate reaction was stop. Like, stop what you're doing. Stop investing money on this and just stop, right? So, as you guys know that I'm not gonna tell you something that I would not do myself. So I told them to stop, liquidate your inventory, ship it to your home, right? Get rid of it, don't pay storage fees or anything, and try to sell it on eBay or wherever else you can, and because this is gonna take a lot of time for you. So, nonetheless, it's one of the most important stories because it teaches you a very vital lesson that product research 101 is very important. You gotta know the core essentials of product research. So before you get into a product, you need to know what to get. You need to know what you're gonna be selling. You need to know why you will be selling it. You need to know if it's profitable and you need to know if it's seasonal and all that such. So what I wanted to do is take this time to go over product research because I know it's one of the main things that a lot of us struggle with. So let's go over the five core essentials of product research that is absolute crucial before you get into a product on Amazon FBA, because again, guys, Amazon FBA is all about finding profitable products and selling them, right? So if you're not gonna do that research, right, what is the point of Amazon FBA? You can't just sell anything and everything, especially if it's a product you think is gonna sell. Like, for example, one product that I always tell people, like, which I'm very passionate about, is art, right? But I would never sell art because I know it's a niche market, it's a luxury market, it's not a need, and it has a very specific market. So I know I'm not gonna be profitable with that, so why would I get into it? That's the moral of this story, guys. So he was not happy to hear what I was telling him. He, your first reaction is to defend your product, right? So he started throwing reasons at me and I calmly explained to him that this is why I'm telling you what I'm telling you, because I'm trying to save you storage fees. I'm trying to save you all these other fees that could be costing you down the road, and I can guarantee you that this product is not gonna sell. So again, guys, product research 101 is very important. When you're doing product research, you go through five essential core research techniques or research strategies that you need to consider before getting into a product, right? The first one is reviews. You gotta know when you're researching a product and you're researching similar products online, you gotta know how many reviews are these products getting. So if a product is getting thousands of reviews and it's selling, like, remember, guys, Jungle Scout Chrome extension is very important with this, right? So it allows you to see how many reviews these products have, the price ranges, the profitability, the seasonality, and all that kind of stuff. So you gotta see in that market or in that category, the products that are selling or the sellers that are already selling these products, how many reviews do they have? That will tell you right off the bat how stiff competition is, right? So when you know that you get into that product, you know who you're competing against. You have to know your competition by analyzing their reviews. If it's a product that has like thousands of reviews, I highly recommend you don't get into it, because especially like if there are like multiples of sellers with thousands of reviews. If it's one, okay, you don't need a big market, but you're trying to break into it, you need, and the rest of the competition is not as stiff, you can definitely get into it, right? So, but I'm telling you guys, if the review range that you want to stay in, like in categories, is on average about 75 to 100 reviews for the category. Anything above that is a little bit harder to get into, but it's not impossible, because I don't want to, you know, take you guys away from categories that that could be like really beneficial down the road, but right now there's a seller with thousands of reviews and all that. But nonetheless, guys, if you're a newbie and you don't want to lose money and you can't take risks like a lot of six-figure sellers can, or other sellers that are successful can, I highly suggest that you guys consider reviews. It's very important. Number two, guys, sales and revenue numbers. You guys have heard me talk about this, that anything that's selling over 5K, that's what you're gonna get into a month, that is, right? And there's a reason for that, because there are so many costs associated and you wanna have at least 50% profit margin. So with a $5,000 sales a month, you're looking at 50%, let's say, margin. The rest of the 50% is your Amazon FBA fees, your product cost, and the shipping cost to ship it to an Amazon warehouse. So you're looking at $2,500 a month profit margin on that product. On that just one product. So that's why you never also stay with one product. So if you bring it down to, let's say, selling $2,000 a month, right? Now you're all of a sudden, you're looking at $1,000 profit margin. But some of you guys may tell me that, okay, that's still a good profit margin, right? Like $1,000 a product, and if you have 5-6 products, each one doing similar numbers, you're making good money. Yes, but the problem is that you're not accounting for PPC campaigns and in advertising that you'll need to do. So for a $5,000 product, you're making 50% margin on it, right? But consider another 500-600 on PPC campaigns and to get the sales that you want. So at the end of the day, you're looking at like $2,000 profit. So if you're doing $1,000 profit and you spend another $500 on advertising, you're literally left with $500. So that's why I don't want you guys to get into anything below $5,000. And of course, anything higher is great. You don't want to start with like really high number either. You want to make sure you're in a category that's competition is not too stiff again, guys, and the numbers are looking good. Okay, number three, price. You guys have heard me talk about this, that anything above $20 or below $20, you don't want to get into. That's $20 American. Because again, guys, like you got to consider your production costs. You got to consider your FBA fees. So in your shipping costs. So normally, let's say if you can manufacture a product for like $4 or $5, and then you consider similar amount for your FBA fees, and then half of that for your shipping costs, you're looking at $12. So all of a sudden you're left with $8 profit, right? And then take out your PPC campaigns and advertising. So that's per unit. So what you want to do is you want to give yourself enough room so you can advertise, so you can push your product out. But if you're selling something that is $10 and your, let's say your Amazon FBA fees and everything comes to $6, you're left with $4. And then if you do advertising, you're literally left with $2 profit margin, which is not much. So I also don't want to discourage you guys from getting into smaller products, but unless your manufacturing cost is like 10 cents per unit, which is possible in some cases, then okay, sure, maybe you can do that. But other than that, you're not gonna have enough profit margin to play with once your product starts selling. So that's why I highly recommend anything between $20 and $30 is great. More expensive items are great as well, but you gotta understand why people are on Amazon, why they're buying items on Amazon. That's because they're looking for a decent quality at a great price. So Amazon is known that the average price, selling price of products on Amazon is about like $20 to $50. That's the range you're playing with. So consider those analysis, consider those numbers in your math when you're trying to do product research, because that's gonna tell you where you need to be, where the market is, what kind of products actually are fall within that price range and what's in demand and all, and as such. So price is absolutely important. It's number three on my list, but it's absolutely important when you're trying to find profitable products. Okay, guys, this is one that I'm really passionate about. At the same time, I know a lot of people make a lot of mistakes on this, and it's your listing. Basically having a great listing, from copyright to photographs to the description to the bullet points of your listing, these are all absolutely important. Now, if you're getting into a product and you don't have professional photos taken, or you don't have the money or the budget to take professional photographs, ask your supplier, because most of the time, the pictures that they post on Alibaba, they actually have those professional pictures, and you can request that and they'll give it to you for free. That could be part of your deal when you're trying to buy from them. So having professional pictures is vital. You guys know that anytime you are trying to search something, you want quality pictures. When you don't see quality, all of a sudden it says something about the product, right? When you see that somebody, the seller, did not put the time and effort to create a great listing, a compelling listing, right? You judge their product accordingly. Because you're like, okay, if they didn't pay attention to their listing, right? Did they actually pay attention to the product they are selling? Are they even passionate about it? Are they even like into this product? So that's why, guys, taking proper pictures, producing a marketable copy is very important. Bullet points is straightforward. Make sure that your product name is in there. The description is absolutely important. Make sure you have all the specs. That's very important. Make sure the specs are all in there, because a professional listing will actually keep the buyer on your page and it will turn them into buyers. So that's it. Like, guys, you want to make sales, you want to increase your sales velocity. These things are absolutely important. Number five, the fifth thing, which is actually A and B, two parts to it, is patents and seasonality. Patents are important to check because you don't want to get sued by the patent holder. I've seen this time and time again where people get into products, they're excited, they start selling, their sales are going great, and all of a sudden Amazon stops them, there's a patent, and the patent holder is trying to sue them. Like, this happened, that a person was selling a product in Canada, in Toronto, and then the patent holder was in California. Found it, I don't know how they found it, but found out, and then they sued them. So that lawsuit is still going on, and it's something you don't want to get into, because once you're flagged by Amazon, chances of you trying to use that same account or start selling again with the same credentials is very hard, guys. So avoid patents. Make sure you are not in the red. Now, seasonality is another thing. Now, I know that seasonal products can be profitable, right? I've sold them and it can be very profitable during Christmas times or winter time and all that kind of stuff. But if you're a new Amazon seller, it is highly recommended that you don't get into it, because you don't have experience with the fluctuations of the market, with how that season works, with the competition, how stiff that is, the manufacturing times, the shipping times, and all that stuff, because keeping a healthy inventory becomes very important during seasonal products, and it will actually take you a season to build that more like a base, right? So that you know what exactly happens with its product in the season, so you have something to project for your next year. So for that reason, I highly discourage new buyers, new sellers, to avoid seasonal products, as you could lose a lot of money if you don't know what you're doing, guys. So, but then again, it could be profitable if you know what you're doing and you have experience with Amazon FBA for a while. So if you do, then yes, get into it. If not, try to avoid it, guys, okay? Thank you so much, guys. I hope this video helped you guys. I'm gonna make another one. We're gonna go through product research, the 5 points that I talked about today. We're gonna get into a little bit deeper, and I'm gonna show you guys the practical examples of what I'm talking about. So this way I'll help you guys. Now, I know I made a video, which was my second YouTube video, on product research, but I'm gonna go a little bit deeper, and I'm gonna show you guys the tools that I use again, and how to search for profitability, and how to do a proper product research from A to Z, guys. Thank you so much. If you're a new viewer, welcome. Please subscribe, like this video if you liked it, drop a comment below if you have any questions or comments, and I'd love to hear from you guys and answer your questions. Thanks again, guys. Have a wonderful day, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.